iOS has changed the way we interact with our iPads with drag and drop. You can now drag and drop items within and between apps using intuitive gestures. In this video tutorial, we'll show you how to use drag and drop to organize your music in OnSong. From my home screen, I'm going to open the New Files app. Now I'll browse to my songs. And once I see something I want to add, I tap and hold it until the item lifts. This means I can now drag that around. While I have a finger on that, I can tap other files to be dragged as well. Now I'm going to go into OnSong. You'll notice I'm dragging those files with one hand, and I navigate into the Songs menu and into the Set tab with my other hand. I'll create a new set. Now I can drop the files into the set list, and after a few moments, the files are imported into my library and immediately added to my set. Let's say I want to add some songs already in my library. I can go over to the Songs tab, and I'll do the same thing. Tap and hold an item until it lifts. I can now flip through my library and tap additional songs to add to the files I'm dragging. When I'm all done, I'll switch to the Set tab and place the songs in my list where I want them. Of course, the songs in my set list may not be in the order I'm going to play them. I can once again tap and hold until the song lifts up and then drag the song where I like. When I release it, the set is immediately updated. Reordering with drag and drop works anywhere in OnSong where you could sort a list in editing mode. Now that we have the set just the way we like, we can export that just as easily. I'm going to go back so that I can view a list of my sets. Then I'll tap and hold until the set lifts, indicating that I can drag it. Now with my other hand, I'm going to swipe up from the bottom of the screen to reveal the dock, and then tap on the Files icon to drag it up to the side. This puts me into a split view multitasking mode in iOS, and lets me view OnSong and the Files app at the same time. Then I can simply drag the set into the Files app and place it where I like. In a few moments, I have a PDF file containing all the songs in my set. What's great about drag and drop is that OnSong can adapt to the types of files that each app can support. These types are placed in an order to help other apps determine what format is preferred. That's why a PDF file is sent to Files. If we want to change the type of file that gets exported, we can do that in OnSong. I'm going to open the Share menu by tapping on this square icon with an arrow, and then tap Export. Let's deselect any formats that might have been selected, and then I'm going to choose the OnSong archive file format. Now I'll go out to my Songs menu and choose Songs at the bottom. I can then drag and drop a song into the Files app, and instead of a PDF file, I'll get an OnSong archive which could be imported and used natively in the OnSong app. Whether you're looking to import songs, images or videos for lyrics backgrounds, backing tracks, or just looking to organize and order your library, there's a good chance OnSong running on an iOS-enabled iPad will give you a new way to get in touch with your music.